So we are now back with Hald in this quest. He thinks that he needs to visit the Grand Cathedral to get some more information about the Holy Church. He also is intrigued by Byrgenwerth and wants to find a way to Byrgenwerth. Is feeling pretty well about himself. He's feeling pretty powerful. This is just he just described his mind with the world of another one. Decides to investigate a little bit more before going at the plaza. If he finds any more information. And he ends up in the plaza. Lots of madman knowledge around the plaza. Maybe when things started getting really dark in the army, some of those guys with some insight came to the plaza working as, I don't know, who these players. Maybe they were feared by the... They were feared by the populace and killed, if it's possible. Maybe at the beginning of the things, before people start seeing monsters everywhere. If they are there, just a bit invisible. Actually forgot to talk with the old man. If I see any statue that is different, so I'll look at it for now. I think all the statues are about just people pleading to the sky. There are just many of them. I don't know if some of them are supposed to be brain suckers. Like this one. Oh, they've got an important detail. There's messengers worshipping it. It seems like a hooded figure. Maybe a brain sucker. I've only saw one brain sucker so far. It was really quick, but he wonders if it's a brain sucker and is worshipped by the little ones, the messengers. Does that mean that he will become a brain sucker too? Is that the evolution of beings worshipped by the little ones? Meanwhile, Ald remembers that this guy over here arrived.
Ah,
I sent you to Sefka.
The swindling off-comer. Did you really think that'd work? No fooling me. Now, off with you. You heard me. Go away. I can't stand the stench of your lying breath.
Should have gone to your Sefka. But anyway, since you're here, anything that you want to talk about? Do you want to say anything at all?
I'll spare you one nugget of advice. Beware the blind man. There the beggar sits at the bottom of the bloody food chain. And then he's here acting like he owns the place. It's not to be trusted. What's he want with all those people anyway? That little weasel has a murky past, I'm telling you.
Are you serious? He is blind? That guy over there, he is blind?
Give it a rest, please. I've no time for your petty lies. And what, just go away now. I can't stand the stench of your lying breath.
I cannot also stand the stench of your lying breath. Hey Johnny, did that stupid guy over there cause you any trouble?
Ah, the hunter. Thank you. So that old man, you told him about this place, right? Well, he don't offer me much in the way of conversation, but still, I'd rather see him alive anyhow. And I sort of hope that my asking you turn out to, you know, help him out in the end. I've never been any use to anyone, you see. Just happy about it, is all.
I would say that you are of use of warriors used to us all, and one of the nicest people I found in the night. Thank you for being so nice.
If you find any sane survivors, well, send them a knock to Erden Chapel, will you?
Hey, Ariana. Got any blood?
Oh, hello. Sorry, dear. You're much too eager. Only so much blood, okay?
Hey, lady. Shall we make up? And be friends?
You! Stay away from me!
So Hal decides, let me see if I find a way to Byrgenwerth. Let me explore that alley where the whore and the old man were. I didn't see that completely. Let me check to see if I can find any info or the way to Byrgenwerth. At this time of the game also thinks that everything that he's doing is righteous. So he feels no guilt at all. Foggy London, the psychos on the streets. Mood. It's funny, so I don't know. Like a werewolf in the middle of the fog. He's got this imagery, which is cool. So here we got some really inspired, everything is quite inspired by Lovecraft, but this thing is inspired by Lovecraft. It's important to point out that this also be important to point out that H.P. Lovecraft is a overrated piece of shit, fucking racist, and really a repentant racist really stupid person that was afraid of everything that was different from him. And yeah, he's overrated. He wasn't a good writer. He had some nice ideas, I give him that. And this whole, the whole cosmic horror, the part that is his creation, is actually very good and very, very important, even philosophically, but the guy was a piece of shit, so I like this more. It's, I think it actually is a bit subverting H.P. Lovecraft's thing, despite being an actual homage, but it's got the whole racism and xenophobia thing being part of Beasthood, and yeah, the heroes in Lovecraft are usually these guys that dismantle cults, mainly made by minorities that worship like these old gods. And here, like, everyone is quite white and Victorian, so they clearly taken like the racism out of the adaptation, and they put it on another way, like racism and xenophobia being part of the first stage of like Beasthood, which is quite cool. So Hulk, during his trips, he finds a message saying the watchman of Byrgenwerth guards the gate with the password, the sacred adage of the Grand Cathedral. So he now knows that, okay, he's quite sure that his destination is over there to the Grand Cathedral, because it's both where he hopes to find some more information of blood. Have to remember that he's looking for pale blood, and might also be the way to go to Byrgenwerth. These guys are can be a complicated enemy sometimes, and they take insight, and you don't get it back. Insight is not a very valuable commodity, but yeah, it's helpful and it's cool to have insight. There's lots of a few mechanics change the more insight you have. Like with 15 or 50 insight, you start seeing some monsters, and at 60 insight, there's a parrot that repeats everything that Hulk says or thinks. The game just becomes very confusing. Really like the parrot mechanic. Just great vistas, great views. Okay, there's the sun. There seems to be a forest over there. Mills. Statues, people. Placing the air, placing the sky, whatever.
The password.
No,
The door it was.
Rush to the conclusion that this is the door to Byrgenwerth, that this is the watchman. Now we just need to find the secret Arash. The healing church. To let the watchman know. So the watchman can let us go through. Seems simple enough. So all this now going to the cathedral. There is a boss nearby. And I think that if I upgrade the character, I will just destroy that boss. So I think I'll go without upgrading. Just have a full of fights. This is also supposed to pick a brain sucker. Besides, just to have a look here on the right. Because he's fearing that there might be something dangerous over there. Notice is this area that seems quite secret, but there's what seems to be a church over there. So Hald decides to explore. Full of hunters and decides to strategically just go away before he gets to. Maybe not. This level, which is actually making a really cool fight. Quickly regrets going this way as you find two hunters and he wonders what kind of hunters are these. So they were not blood hunters, none of them used any sort of blood art. The tonitrous might be reinforced with blood, but it's a kind of a different weapon. The other also relied a lot on shooting, on gunpowder. They're also not chosen by the dream, or if they are chosen by the dream, they're at the end of their loops, because these guys do not respond. Although I'm not sure, I'm thinking now that there are two guys that show up on the nightmare. So I wonder if those guys died and were passed through the nightmare. I need to check if they are the same guys next time we go to the Hunter's Nightmare. Well, I might as well explore this area. Do you know anything about pale blood?
Bless us with blood. Bless us with blood.
Do you know the adage of the healing church? Is it bless us with blood? Doesn't say much. So I think he's praying for a bloody hunt, which makes perfect sense. So he wants the beasts to be killed, so he wants to the hunt to is praying to be a bloody hunt, so there's lots of beasts, and then there's the blood that also got some healing properties. So yeah, blood is a blessing, and I'll start really seeing that, okay, this healing church is really the mainstream religion of Yarnham. Everyone likes blood.
This is with blood.
But okay, the blood has got powers. And it's got very powerful healing properties. So the church kind of controls life in Yarnham, because the church are the ones that control the blood, pretty much. So Ald decides that he's not powerful enough to go forward, and decides just, okay, let's just have to at the cathedral, see if we find anything interesting. Maybe a piece of paper talking about Byrgenwerth. Oh, there's something over here. Okay. So apparently I can inscribe Master's Lawrence Adage upon my flesh. Master Lawrence must have been a very important member of the church. And German is waiting for him. It's the second time Lawrence is mentioned. And Alp is pretty much puzzled with all of this. And he's starting to think, am I a heir to the ritual of blood? Am I a purveyor administration? I think I am. Okay. Ald is a bit scared now. And this is the end of the video.